Several of our videos have been demonetized after human review by YouTube representatives, which is why we emphasize that our videos are 100% educational, are not intended to glorify or promote the use of any substance, and strictly fall into the category of videos suitable for monetization according to YouTube policies, under these specific sections. Please don't demonetize our videos, they take a lot of effort, money, study, and dedication to make. According to this ABC News article, in 2022 the DA seized enough fentanyl to kill by overdose the entire population of the United States. They seized 379 million lethal doses of fentanyl, including more than 50 million fentanyl-containing pills and thousands of pounds of fentanyl powder. You might be thinking this video is not for you or someone you know, since you don't think it's possible that you'll ever consume fentanyl. Let's look at the following images together. These are rainbow fentanyl tablets seized by the DA. They are round colored tablets, which have a stripe running through the middle in their backside, and on the front they have a logo, in this case an M. And these are regular ecstasy tablets. They are colored tablets that have a stripe going through the middle on their backside, and on the front they have a logo. Do you think it's possible for a dealer to substitute one for another, or just make the mistake of offering you the wrong one? We leave this to your discretion. Fentanyl is a deadly substance of abuse, which shouldn't be used recreationally by anyone under any circumstances. In its pure form, just 2 milligrams is enough to kill a person. 2 milligrams of fentanyl fit on the tip of a pencil. So how do they go about creating fentanyl tablets, which are clearly larger than the tip of a pencil? They mix a small portion of fentanyl powder with other psychoactive substances to enhance its effect, in addition to adding extra powder that has no effect to shape the tablet. However, being manufactured clandestinely, the dose of fentanyl added to the mix can vary, and one more milligram can mean the difference between life and death, since just 100 micrograms of fentanyl, 1/10 of a milligram, the same effect is achieved in a person as with 10 milligrams of morphine. This is how more than 68,000 people died in the United States from fentanyl overdoses in 2022. Fentanyl is a very potent synthetic opioid medication, which is regularly used for therapeutic purposes. It works like morphine to generate analgesia, but it is 100 times more powerful than morphine, and 50 times more powerful than heroin. Clinically, its most common use is as a sedative in intubated patients, and in severe cases of pain in patients with renal failure. From time to time, fentanyl may also be indicated to treat patients with chronic pain, who developed tolerance to other less potent but safer opioid medications. However, overdose deaths occur mostly when it's used for recreational purposes. Fentanyl acts on a specific type of opioid receptor in the brain, directly altering our perception of emotions, pain, and reward mechanisms, which makes it highly addictive. In addition, it induces an avalanche of dopamine on the reward zones in our brain, to which its effects of extreme euphoria, pleasure, and relaxation are attributed. However, it is important to remember that fentanyl is known as the zombie drug, and we have all seen one or another video rolling on the internet, starring people who are under its effects. This characteristic way of acting is due to the fact that fentanyl produces dyskinesia, which produces repetitive and involuntary movements. It also produces confusion, auditory and visual hallucinations, delirium, dizziness, and nausea, causing the person to practically take on the personality of a zombie while under its effects. Ultimately, a fentanyl overdose ends in respiratory failure, loss of consciousness, and then death. Fortunately, there is an antidote that can be useful to combat fentanyl overdose if it is administered in a timely manner, naloxone. Naloxone is an opioid antagonist medication. In a clinical setting, it is usually administered intravenously or intramuscularly, but it is highly likely that today you can find intranasal naloxone at your nearest pharmacy. The FDA announced that starting in 2023, naloxone will probably be available for sale without a prescription, as an intranasal 4 mg spray or as a 2 mg self-injector. This with the aim of making it more available to use as an initial antidote while the person arrives at an emergency room. In most cases, administration of this dose of naloxone is safe, and the benefit of avoiding death from opioid overdose outweighs its risks. However, fentanyl is not the only opioid that is abused. There is also morphine, oxycodone, and heroin, for example. Would you like us to make a video talking about any of these substances? Let us know in the comments section. However, the best thing you can do to avoid a fentanyl overdose is to never take it. And to achieve this, there are only two options. Option number one, never consume any synthetic drugs. Option number two, make sure that the drug you are going to consume does not contain fentanyl or other substances that can mean death in low doses. In an ideal world, the first option would be the safest. However, it is time to open your eyes and be objective. We coexist with the consumption of substances of abuse in our daily life. They are in every club, bar, electronic party, or musical event that may exist, and their use is increasing. To say that people will never use substances of abuse is not only wishful thinking, it is impossible. For some reason, more effort is still made to punish substance use than to prevent it or educate about its use. However, we want to know what you think. Do you think its consumption should continue to be prohibited? Or educate yourself about it looking for safe consumption? Let us know in the comments section. So far, substance testing kits are considered drug paraphernalia in most states in the United States and are therefore illegal. However, testing any drug is the only way to be 100% sure that it does not contain any unwanted substance. For this reason, we believe that the legislation will soon migrate towards allowing this type of solution, since the war on drugs in most countries is migrating to be more educational and preventive than prohibitive. However, these testing tools are still illegal in most countries, and we don't know for sure when the policies will change. Our opinion is that banning these types of tools places the population at greater risk, since they will probably continue to consume adulterated substances without having access to testing tools. What do you think? Do you think that these types of solutions will become available and allow people to know what they are consuming with more peace of mind? Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to our channel, and activate the bell if you learn something new. At Tuvi Digital, we have a large library of videos like this. Now you will find two videos that will surely be of interest to you. A hug, see you in the next video.